Hey guys, welcome to another edition of Driving with Miranda on the Car Guide. I have the Jeep Grand Cherokee L. What does that stand for? Long. As you can see, this is the third row or three row Jeep Grand Cherokee. Totally capable off-road and a pleasure and comfort to drive. Let's get behind the wheel and check it out. Inside the Jeep Grand Cherokee L is a lovely place to be. I have the Overland version, so starting in the 60,000 range. There are a few different models of the L available, different trim levels with different features. This one's pretty well stocked, although it doesn't have the full entertainment package in the back. There are models Summit and above, I think, that have the screens in the second row. But basically, I have everything else. Oh, there's also an optional 5.7 liter Hemi. This does not have that. Thankfully, gas prices gonna be okay. So this has the 3.6 liter V6 Pentastar, which is good for 293 horsepower, 260 pound-foot of torque, I believe. What's impressive about the Grand Cherokee L is its towing capacity. So if you have the tow package equipped, which I believe the Overland automatically comes with that, I can tow up to 7,000 pounds, 6,700 or 7,200. It's in that range, which is really good and great for a vehicle like this. And if you're getting a Jeep Grand Cherokee L, chances are you either have a really big family or you're doing stuff that requires a lot of interior space. So there's that. And also, Jeep has brought out this luxurious SUV that in a way rivals Land Rover in terms of like off-road ability and the fact that you can take this thing mudding and rock climbing. And I don't know that you would. I don't think there are many Jeep Grand Cherokees, L's or not, that live that life, but they have that option because it's got the select terrain, kind of like their drive mode. So I can go from rock to sand mud to snow to sports. And I also have 5 different ride heights. So there is suspension settings that I have, from aerodynamic to entry exit level to super high up, so that your undercarriage is not going to hit anything that you decide to off-road over. This also has a super high water rate wading height, so you can go through small little rivers or whatever and not worry about drowning out your engine. Truly an off-road capable vehicle, which is kind of shocking for everything else that it has inside, you know, from the massaging seats, which are lovely, by the way, although quite loud. They make this like airy noise when they're doing their thing. Kind of makes you want to turn the volume up on the radio a little bit more. I've got like all surround view cameras. I have the fam cam, which I first showed you guys in the Chrysler Pacifica. So same thing here in the third row, there's a dome camera that you can zoom in and check on your kids or anybody really sitting back there with the entertainment system up here, which I think is pretty cool. I have night vision, which truthfully I haven't used and I've never used in cars that come equipped with night vision. I feel it might be a little bit more distracting. However, having driven really dark country roads in the middle of the night that have zero lights anywhere, I do see the value in it. And if you do a lot of driving like that, or you're out on a camping trip or wherever and you're in the woods and you don't want to hit either random branches or creatures, it stands to play a vital role to your safe driving. I also have a 10.1 inch screen up here, all touchscreen, beautiful. I've got a charge pad, plenty of storage, lots of USB ports. I've got 4 up here, 4 in the second row, and I believe the third row has as well. And room for seven, super comfy. My kid, who now has graduated to the front seat of vehicles because he's a giant, spent most of the week up here in front with me enjoying the massaging seat, which he has never been able to enjoy before. But he did sit in the back for a little bit and agreed that it was super spacious, and he has like the sunscreen so he can protect himself and not boil under the sunlight back there, and just really easy to get in and out of as well. And then the trunk, I've got plenty of trunk space back there, especially with the third row down. And those are super easy to put down, little buttons on the side, kind of slow, but you know, that's okay. Better than them flopping forward suddenly or accidentally with somebody in the third row. Now, when it comes to driving this thing, I really like it. It's smooth, it's comfortable. Maybe the V6 feels a little bit underpowered for the size of this car, that it, you know, it feels like it could have a little bit more, and that it's bottom heavy when you accelerate. But, you know, would I put the Hemi in this for that extra oomph? No, not right now. I don't think it's necessary. The 3.6 is more than enough. It has an 8-speed automatic transmission. I have paddle shifters. I didn't use them. Again, didn't feel the need to. Maybe given a situation, you know, inclement weather, snow, off-roading, yes, I would. But my everyday city driving, no, I didn't. Overall, just a really comfortable vehicle. And yeah, it's got a high price tag, but it's got a lot in it and a lot going for it. You know, this isn't just a bare bones edition of the Grand Cherokee L. Like I said, this is the Overland. So you're getting a lot of bang for your buck. And while you are dishing out quite a few bucks, at least you're getting something back in return. So yeah, I think it's super, you know, it's not the Grand Wagoneer, right? We've been through with that. It's just a little bit, well, not a little bit actually, it's quite a lot below the Wagoneer, but you're getting all of those kind of same features, the 3-row, the lots of space, the tech, the can, you know, all those little things for a fraction of the price of the Wagoneer. Materials are definitely different. You know, I don't have the finishing that I had in the Wagoneer. So they've made that distinction, which I think is really important too, because here's another 3-row Jeep. And they're like, well, why would you have both? And they are very similar to look at. But they've made that distinction between the two, and enough of a distinction that you could justify, you know, either spending more for the Wagoneer or settling, which you're not, or choosing the Jeep Grand Cherokee L. And when it comes to the exterior look of this thing, I adore it. I love Jeeps. I love that front end. I think it's super cool that every single Jeep has the same grille. You know who you are. You know when one's coming towards you on the road. And of course, like I said, this does look very similar to the Grand Wagoneer. Not as big and square, but same front end, same shape, same silhouette. Of course, it doesn't say, you know, Grand Cherokee super big across the back like Wagoneer says it across. But that little badging, I love the little L, and then it's got like the long box just to remind you that you're in a long version of the Grand Cherokee. And inside materials, like I said, I love the contrast stitching. I've got wood grain in here. Super fantastic, excellent Macintosh sound system. No matter where you're sitting in this car, it sounds phenomenal. And then a massive, huge moonroof that stretches all the way to the second row. Nice big windows, no matter where you sit here. Like, you can even see that third row there has a really nice big window. You're never gonna feel trapped or stifled in this car. Perfect for long road trips, perfect for family getaways. And like I said, you've got that towing capacity. So, you know, if you have a boat, if you, you know, off-road, you've got your ATVs, you want to take them off somewhere, here is the vehicle for you, especially if you have that, you know, 2.4 children, whatever, that most of us are supposed to have. This has all the room for that and more. All right, guys, well, that's been it for me in the Jeep Grand Cherokee L. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. I think it's a super cool version of the Grand Cherokee, and it's going to do very well. It has awesome features. It's great to drive, and yeah, it has a big price tag, but you know what? This is a big car, and you pay for what you get, and you get plenty inside this Grand Cherokee. As always, if you have any questions or comments, you can hit me up at Miss Miranda L on Twitter or Instagram, Miranda Lyston on Facebook.com, or you can drop a comment below. Enjoy the sunshine, guys, and I hope to see you back next week.